After 22 years of war, the lives and communities that the Northern Ugandans were forced to leave behind had been destroyed. One of the most important issues for people in the resettlement process was education for their children. Women Leading Change was able to start almost immediately with the construction of a girls' school called a tanga. At the same time, we visited an elementary school in the region called Patongo. These students had also suffered unspeakable atrocities during the war. The school itself was collapsing, and the community was desperate for funds to rebuild it. But at the time, we couldn't help. 2 years later, when we visited Patongo again, the school had decayed even further and still had no prospects for help. The isolation of this school meant that if we didn't raise the funds to rebuild it, it could be years before someone else might come along with either the potential or the desire to help. This time, we didn't walk away. We've now built 5 schools in 5 years, but enrollment is growing faster than we anticipated, and with it, the need for more classrooms and science labs, more dormitories and beds, and more dining halls and libraries. Building outstanding learning institutions that turn out excellent students is our primary goal. From these schools, an abundance of confident young women will emerge to guide their communities forward and impress the minds and ambitions of the girls that follow them. And for the girls that aspire to continue their studies towards developing substantial and meaningful careers, Women Leading Change has begun to focus on a new goal, providing university scholarships for the best and the brightest. With more young women joining the professional workforce, the gender imbalance in positions of influence will slowly start to shift. We believe in the capacity women have to create change and balance in a world where men's voices still speak the loudest. We believe education is the way to get there.